These cops have what some call an impossible job, to clean up Oakland's streets of crack dealers.
How old are you?
12.
Crack is corrupting the future. Police officer Pat Heiser is trying to save it.
As bad as it is now, it would be much worse if we weren't out here.
Blue jeans, black tennis shoes. Grab them.
There's the car. See the car?
These two guys right there with the black. See the gun in the black jacket? Just dropped it. Just dropped it with his left hand.
Turn around, man. Turn around.
On the streets, Heiser and his fellow officers are known as the task force.
See what he dropped?
What?
He dropped our money.
What's the numbers on the building down there? That's our money. I think it looks good to the community because they're getting immediate results. And we make a buy, and the buyouts make a buy, and those suspects are generally under arrest within 30 seconds to a minute.
Open your mouth!
The task force started sweeping the city almost 4 years ago.
Spit it out! Spit it out! Open your mouth! Yeah, she ate most of it. We got a few chips back.
Thousands of suspected dealers have been taken off the streets, but Heiser says they don't stay off long enough.
I think that if I was sentencing them, I would sentence them to longer sentences because they keep telling us the rest of the dope dealers, we're sick of the dope in the city and the menace and all that, so we go out there and do whatever we can to arrest them. And we have to arrest them 3 or 4 times just to put them in prison.
You on parole?
Yeah.
Later.
What are you on parole for?
You might want to
robbery.
Finish that ground while we're
robbery?
In there, too. Right at the curve.
Who wants to pull in there?
Stand right here and face the light.
The task force measures its success by the number of arrests the officers can make in one night. An average night is, say, 15 to 17 arrests. So far, the exceptional night has been 27 arrests.
He's out here, we had 77 arrests. I'm in again. Plenty of additional.
He's out
of going outside.
We're going to have to stop from being brought into the city. If that's possible, I don't know. I think that we can at least control it so that it isn't an open market and that the people aren't out here killing each other over a $20 rock.
Black leather jacket threw up on the roof, correct?
Yes, he did. The first one you got there, the smallest guy out there, tossed up. Looks like he threw up to the roof.
How many rocks you throw up there, dude? It's going to take much more than what we're doing and probably the resource that we have right now to stop the cocaine from coming to Oakland.
We got 5 here and 1 on the ground, 6.
Ready for heaven.
None of us are going to save the world out here. I don't think that's why we're out here. But if we clean up one street a night, then that's one less street that people have to worry about. Where do you live? What's that?
What, Leo?
The task force says one out of every 10 suspected dealers they arrest is a kid under the age of 18. Mac.
Sherry, how can they keep doing that night after night after night after night? The burnout rate must be very high.
Well, really, in the 4 years that the task force has been in existence now at the Oakland Police Department, officers say they last about a year in that job. They're aggressive officers. They have to go out and make the arrests. They have to go out and solicit those buys. So you can imagine you just don't sit back and answer a call. You're out there every night.
I guess.
It's tough.
What have you got for us tomorrow night?
Well, tomorrow we deal with crack and the community. We're going to be looking at the other frontline soldiers in the battle against drugs, people who are afraid, but more afraid of not fighting back. And that's tomorrow night at 11 on Nightcast.
Thank you, Sherry.
Mac.